Today's American Story with Bob Dotson features two of the country's most successful inventors. You probably don't know them, but you'll definitely be familiar with their work. This is their first time on TV, and Bob found them in a place as unusual as their ideas.
This old church was down to a congregation of termites until it cleared its throat and made a joyful noise. John Spirk and his best buddy John Nottingham have turned it into an invention factory.
Why a church? Why not?
It's inspiring.
You probably own one of their ideas. Their products earn billions. 464 of them. Only Thomas Edison filed more money-making patents. And he's not filing anymore.
Haven't you ever been in the kitchen and you pick up something and say, they should do a thing? Well, we're the they.
Meet your new best friend, the highly addictive Dove Skin Vitalizer Facial Cleanser.
Most inventors feel they have to create something revolutionary, brand new, never been done before in the history of mankind.
Broom and dustpan letting you down? Get the Swiffer Sweeper.
That's wrong, because everything is a variation on something that existed in the past.
Okay, why?
So Nottingham and Spirk look for things we already use, then dream up ways to improve an old idea.
Look at that, Brian. I mean, this thing hasn't been changed in 100 years.
I think they're built by the Amish, that's why.
Yeah, I'm gonna turn it on.
Their latest? A water-powered broom.
We gotta adjust that right side.
Okay.
You know, this one's hanging up over here.
All this started in a little cafe. The two began the business with only $600, but a million ideas. Designed their company logo on a bridge walking home. Sealed the deal with a handshake.
There we go. I think we may have a new sport here.
Yeah. Everybody thought we're nuts. Including us a little bit.
After all, their dads worked in steel mills.
Yeah.
But their partnership has lasted as long as their marriages. All their kids work here now. Rachel Nottingham has been testing toys since she was 2.
I had no idea that it was for his job. I thought he just brought me fun toys to play with. So.
I remember those moments your dad comes to school day. You know, what does your dad do? We were always superstars.
We're always mobbed.
Because, oh my God, your dad like makes candy things and toy things, and who could be better than that?
Yeah.
The two still share an office.
Mindlessly convenient.
Even though the church they fixed up has 60,000 square feet.
Do you compete or do you work together?
Always work together. Whatever it is, it's been a 50-50 partnership from the very beginning.
Because for 35 years, that partnership has helped them do better than they thought they could.
How do you check your egos?
You really can't have an ego here in this business.
You put the cap on, you shake it up.
They would blind them to good ideas.
We have the Palladium window right over there.
Nottingham and Spirk are successful because they improve every opportunity to wonder. Their genius is the ability to connect the seemingly unconnected. A contractor wanted to charge them $27,000 to paint the church ceiling.
The sky was literally falling.
Instead, they poured their own.
We had a fishing pole and a sponge, and we had a guy up there going thump, thump, thump. That looks pretty good, doesn't it?
It only cost them a 6-pack of beer. For today, Bob Dotson, NBC News, with an American story in Cleveland, Ohio.